there is so much of our science, of all of our science that we do, that involves imagery. Very rarely do you find a scientific paper that doesn't have a picture in it, a figure of some sort. But there's this wonderful aesthetic that goes with some of these pictures that are just beautiful to look at. And so I had this thought, what if we took a huge array of the science that goes on here at the museum, take images, real images used in real science, and put them up on the wall? Some of them will be obvious, like an insect head. Some of them will not be obvious and will look very abstract. And yet each of them hopefully will draw in the visitor in a very aesthetic way and will stimulate curiosity. Oh, look at that, that's really cool. There's a great deal of very good, very hardcore, cutting edge science that goes on at this museum that the average visitor doesn't know about. We have a microscopy and imaging facility, and it has a lot of the state-of-the-art equipment.
This is the Hitachi S4700. It's a scanning electron microscope. It is used for high resolution imaging. There's a door that swings open, and we can insert the sample on the end of this rod into the chamber.
One of the most recent pieces of equipment that was purchased is a CT scanner. This is computed tomography.
What it does is it takes thousands of x-rays that we ask it to take, and then we send those x-rays to a 3D reconstruction program, which can turn it into what we know as CAT scans.
The next step would be to grow out the skulls in three dimensions. And it's interesting, this is the first real attempt to do this with these kind of lizards, to look at the distribution of these armor bones.
What we've done in one case, for example, one of our curators in anthropology had a knife that was stuck in a sheath, and they couldn't get the knife out of the sheath. And he wanted to see if there was any writing on the blade. With computed tomography, they were able to get a three-dimensional density image map of the entire object, strip away in the computer the sheath, and you can see the writing on the blade of the knife in great detail. This is the only exhibit that I know of that has gone up in this museum that cuts across every single scientific department. Some of the material that people will see hasn't even been put out in scientific publications yet. It's really that fresh.